Now we're talking about Mark Zuckerberg's emails. It seems like whenever anybody's under pressure in Washington, email is at the center of it. What does this show about just the level of pressure and scrutiny that companies the size of Facebook are going to continue to be under?
So this is literally a perfect example of what I was saying right before this news broke. This is the mysterious indirect revenue model at work, right? When you have companies like Facebook that make money in a way that is disconnected from the core product experience, it's a cascade of problems. Regulators don't understand the business model, so it's hard to regulate. So there's frustration, so that when things start to turn badly, there's very little sympathy, very little understanding for it. It's hard to know what exactly prioritizing an FTC investigation would mean for a company like that. They've already eroded a lot of trust. I don't at all question Mark Zuckerberg or Sheryl Sandberg's motivation. I don't question their character, their motivation, their morals. I think they're both, as far as I know, excellent, upstanding people that want the right thing. But they're running a company whose revenue model makes it really tough to just do the correct thing. And if you look at the four big tech companies, the two that have to wind up having to apologize the most, it seems like, are Facebook and Google, the two with indirect revenue models. And the two giant companies that, for the most part, don't have nearly the same problems are Amazon and Apple. And it's because people understand how Amazon makes money. People understand how Apple makes money. There's a lot more sympathy. There's a lot more clarity. And it's important for these companies to do the right thing for their customers, because their customers are what makes money.
You know, Microsoft, which arguably Microsoft, is bigger than
all of them. Exactly. And Microsoft also, arguably, the fact that Microsoft has kind of failed years ago, historically, in making a big ad business or even a lot of these, in search. And really what they've done a great job as is just doubling down on making products people want to buy. Like, all of this, 2019 is the year where we should really try to return to simple, old-fashioned business models, where you make money by selling stuff that people or companies want to buy, and it takes care of so many of these problems.
But Facebook and Google got awfully large. Do you think this disconnect that you're talking about contributed to hypergrowth?
Yeah, I think it did, and I think it's a very interesting question about how they should be regulated, whether or not they should be broken up. There's been a lot of conversation over the past few weeks about that. I think we need to be very intentional when we're discussing these things about, well, what problems are we trying to solve? How will these things solve the problem versus would they make them worse necessarily? But the fact that people are so fundamentally confused about how these companies even make money even makes these discussions harder, because people will just lash out and say, we'll just break them up. Well, is that going to make things better or worse? I don't think most people know. I don't think I know. But in the medium term, I think what we need to do is what investors should do is put their money into companies with understandable direct business models. Ask yourself, look at your portfolio and say, do I inherently grok how each of these companies makes money? And is the way they make money by making a better product for the people who use the product, or is it something else? And I would steer towards the ones with very understandable business models.